Good morning, students. Welcome to online classes. My name is Jerenka Devi. I am working in AP Residential School, Gutti, Anantapur. Today, we are going to learn about national moments. First of all, what is meant by national moments? National moments for freedom against the Britishers. So, our national leaders against the Britishers for independent India. This is called a national moments. Basically, national moments are three types. Moderate phase, extremist phase, and Gandhian era. Moderate phase, 1885 to 1905. And extremist phase, 1905 to 1920. And Gandhian era, 1920 to 1947. Four national movements in India, number of associations formed, like East Indian Association. In 1866, Dadabhai Nawroji established East Indian Association. And after various leaders like Surendranath Banerjee, K.C. Ranade, Subramanyam Iyer, etc. Number of national leaders forms number of associations. Finally, they form the big association that is called Indian National Congress. Indian Congress. Now here three questions arise. One of the when was the established the Indian National Congress and who was the founder of National Congress and president in INC. First question, in 1885 Indian National Congress established. Founder A.O. Hume. First President W.C. Banerjee. So these are very important bits in national moments. And after when our Indian National Congress established the main aim of struggles and achievements, aims and goals through the peaceful methods. And another aim, INC means Indian National Congress. Another aim, Indian National Congress, nationalistic zeal and in the unity of intellectuals. These are main aim of the Indian National. Now I am telling about moderate phase, 1885 to 1905. During the first 20 years in Indian National Congress led by the leaders who were called moderates. The main moderate leaders like Gopalakrishna Gokhale, Dadabhai Nawroji, Firoz Shah Mehta, Subramanyam Iyer, J.C. Ranade. These are main leaders in moderate leaders. I am telling about a few words in some moderate leaders like Gopalakrishna Gokhale. Gopalakrishna Gokhale was also known as father of national movements. He was also political guru of Mahatma Gandhi. Gopalakrishna Gokhale established one society, the Servants of Indian Society. And a few words, Dadabhai Nawroji. Dadabhai Nawroji also called Grand Old Man of India. Means Bharata Desa Kuruvruddhu. He also write the one economic book. This is called Dry Theory. So, murders are follow the peaceful methods. What are the demands of the moderate leaders? First one, arouse the public opinion. First of all, arouse the public opinion. And second one, to demand modern industries. Third one, demand to conduct the civil service examinations in India and participate in Indians also. And third one, treatment of the Indian laborers to abroad and suffering the forest dwellers caused the and interference the forest department to remove that. Moderates follow the three principles. One of the pray, second one petition, and third one protest. These are main principles of moderate leaders. First, they want to request to pray. Second, they want to request to petition. So, moderates first meeting resolutions for the British government. Second, they request to wrote to appeal the British government. Third one, these ideas are follow the democratic ideals. These are main principles of the moderate leaders. But how to reach the moderates to the peoples? Moderates reach the people some methods. They are conduct the meetings and through the newspapers and through the tours. Anyhow, moderate leaders are very important role in Indian national movements. So, moderate leaders are activities are some benefits for Indian people. They are awareness of Indian peoples and how to struggle for independence India. These are some benefits of moderate leaders. But moderate leaders activities are criticize the some leaders. How to criticize the leaders? Moderates are activities are criticize the leaders. Moderates are begging the request of the Britishers. Moderates are requesting for the independence. Some leaders like Arvind Ghosh, Balagangadhar Tilak question why were the begging? Only demand for the Britishers. So in this time, Balagangadhar Tilak announced one slogan: Swaraj is my birthright, I shall have it. After moderates, next second phase start. That is extremist phase. Now I am telling about extremist phase. First of all, who were the extremists? Who means who were follow the rash methods, who were follow the serious methods, that leaders are called extremist. The main methods of extremists: no argument, no request, no begging. They should only demand. These were called extremists. So, most important extremists are, first of all, Aravind. Aravind Ghosh. Second one, Balagangadhar Tilak. Third, Lala Lajpat Rai. Fourth one, Balagangadhar Tilak. The familiar name was Lal Bal Pal. Lal means Lala Lajpat Rai. Bal means Balagangadhar Tilak. Pal means Bipin Chandra Pal. Now a few words about the Aravind Ghosh. Aravind Ghosh was the also called father of extremist of Indian national movements. He was ICS student, but he resigned the ICS post and joined the Indian national movements for sacrificing the motherland. And another important leader, Balagangadhar Tilak. Balagangadhar Tilak was born Maharashtra. His title was Lokamanya Balagangadhar Tilak. He also wrote two books. One of the Gita Rahasya and second one Archaic Home of Veda. And he also published the two papers. One of the Kesari and second one Maratha. He announced the one slogan. Swaraj is my birthright and I shall have it. Another important leader, Lala Lajpat Rai. Lala Lajpat Rai, his title, Punjab Kesari. Unfortunately, he was died in Lati Charge. Because of 1928, Simon Commission was there in at Lahore. He was opposed to the Simon Commission. But the British officer, ACP Standard, attacked the Lati Charge. In this Lati Charge, Lala Lajpat Rai was injured very much. Because of injured, he was died in the Lati Charge. Next, another leader, Bipin Chandra Pal. Bipin Chandra Pal was a great speaker. He propagated the Vande Mataram movement in South India, like Rajahmundry. And he was a very familiar person in national movements. So, Lal Bal Pal was the most familiar leaders in Indian social movements. First phase, number of movements arose. Number 1, 1905 Vande Mataram movement and 1905 Swadeshi movement and 1916 Home Rule movement and 1919 Jallianwala Bagh incident. And at the same time, in the world, first world was happened. So, this is a very important moment in established period, 1905 Vande Mataram movement. So, what is information of Vande Mataram movement? You know. In 1905, Lord Curzon announced the partition of the Bengal. Why was the partition of the Bengal? At the time of British India, Bengal was a large province in British India. So, the Britishers, these Bengals also include the Bihar, Bengal, Orissa. An ideology by Lord Curzon to divide the Bengal to divide the unity of Hindus and Muslims. So, British policy divide and rule was used in this partition of Bengal. Bengal, east side Muslims and west side Hindus. So, Lord Curzon divide the Hindus and Muslims. So, they wanted to partition of the Bengal. But some peoples not interested in partition of the Bengal. So, they start the one movement that is called Vande Mataram movement. All Indians are joined in this movement. And so, everybody has to wish to others calling Vande Mataram movement. Vande Mataram. In this time, Bagin Chandra Chatterjee wrote to one song, Vande Mataram Geetam. So, this is against the partition of the Bengal. Also, the Vande Mataram movement main activities are burning the foreign class and also foreign goods. Women refuse the foreign bangles and foreign utensils. And boycott the government schools and colleges and courts. And Swadeshi schools and colleges and courts established. Finally, in 1911, cancelled the partition of the Bengal. At the same time, India capital shifted Calcutta to Delhi. So, another more important movement, Swadeshi movement. What is meant by Swadeshi? స్వదేశీ మూమెంట్. స్వదేశీ మూమెంట్ మీన్స్ మ్యాక్సిమం నేషనల్ లీడర్స్ ప్రాపగేటెడ్ ద యూజింగ్ ద స్వదేశీ గూడ్స్ అండ్ స్వదేశీ యుటెన్సిల్స్ స్వదేశీ క్లాస్. అవాయిడ్ ద ఫారిన్ గూడ్స్ అండ్ ఫారిన్ క్లాస్. సో నేను యూజింగ్ ద ఓన్లీ స్వదేశీ గూడ్స్. దిస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ స్వదేశీ మూమెంట్. అనదర్ మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ మూమెంట్ ఇన్ దిస్ పీరియడ్ హోమ్ రూల్ మూమెంట్. హోమ్ రూల్ మీన్స్ సెల్ఫ్ రూలింగ్. దిస్ మూమెంట్ స్టార్టెడ్ బాలగంగాధర్ తిలక్ ఎట్ పూణే ఇన్ 1916. అండ్ అనదర్ మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇన్సిడెంట్ ఇన్ ఎస్టిమిస్ట్ హిస్టరీ జలియన్ వాలా బాగ్ మూమెంట్ ఇన్ 1919.
దీస్ ఆర్ ద జలియన్ వాలా బాగ్ ఇన్సిడెంట్స్ ఇన్ ఇండియా.
I am telling about Jallianwala Bagh movement in 1919. It was the arrest of the local leaders Satyapal Kichlu and Saipuddin Kichlu and Satyapal. The people gathered the one meeting. Why was the meeting conduct? The Britishers introduced the one act that is called Rowlatt Act 1919. What are the information of Rowlatt Act? In this act, any Indian without any information, any arrest warrant, any precautions, any time arrest and put in the jail. So that was caused the Satyapal and Saipuddin Kichlu arrested at Amritsar. The people gathered the meetings. In this place, surrounded high walls for three sides. But people are a peaceful meeting, and this meeting attended the number of men and women and children. Suddenly, Sir Michael O. Dyer, Punjab governor, entered in this park, and without giving any information, any warning to the people, and dispersed his troop, dispersed with troop and open fire for 10 minutes. In this firing, INC opinion, thousands people died and number of peoples injured. This is a very painful incident in extremist phase.
At that time, newspapers were played vital role in national movements. The most important newspaper in Andhra Pradesh that was Krishna Patrika. Krishna Patrika was started in Machilipatnam in 1902. Matnuri Krishna Rao was one of the founder of the paper. The Krishna Patrika carried on publicity for all phases of Indian struggle for movement, like the Vande Mataram movement, Home Rule movement, non-cooperation movement, the civil disobedience movement and Quit India movement. So Krishna Patrika influenced not only urban educated elite but also rural masses.
One incident happened in the world, that is First World War 1914 to 1918. In this World War, Britain, France and Russia one side and Germany and alliances other sides. What were the effect of the First World War? In the First World War, Russian Socialist Revolution started and British were increasing the taxes and Britishers introduced the horse laws. At the same time, Mahatma Gandhi came to India from South Africa. He was also joined the Indian National Movements. Next, Gandhian era started. So, this is a end of the extremist phase. This is a very important role in Indian national movements. So, I am telling about Gandhian era, 1919 to 1947. It is a very important stage in our national movements. Gandhiji played vital role in this stage. We got independence under his leadership. So, Gandhiji is called Father of Nations. Gandhiji made a number of movements in this stage.
Champaran, Satyagrah, Khed, Satyagrah, Ahmedabad Mill Workers Strike, Non-Cooperation Movement, Khilafat Movement and Non-Cooperation Movement, Quit India Movement in 1942 and another important major movements.
These movements led by Mahatma Gandhi. That's why this period was called Gandhian era. Gandhiji arrived from South Africa. He contacted with various types of peoples like Hindus, Muslims, Persians, Tamils and North Indian peoples. When he arrived from South Africa, he spent his first year traveling throughout the country, understanding the people and their problems and their needs. Gandhiji first movements were Champaran Satyagrah and Khed Satyagrah. Where he led peasants or farmers in the struggle against the unfair terms and excess of taxes. Anyhow, he led successful in these movements. Another most important successful movement was Ahmedabad Mill Workers Strike in 1918. Ahmedabad Mill Workers were invited Gandhi to lead the movement. So, in Ahmedabad, he led successful mill workers' strike in 1918. So, these two movements, Gandhiji came into contact with various national leaders like Rabindranath Tagore and Vallabhbhai Patel. These successful movements, Gandhiji became most popular and center of the political activities. In 1919, British government introduced one act, that was Rowlatt Act 1919. In this act, any person who suspected by police of being as a terrorist and could be arrested any time and kept in jail without any trials. So Gandhiji and Muhammad Ali Jinnah criticized the act as a devilish. Gandhiji asked people to observe 6th April 1919, the day of non-violent opposition. People went to hartals, satyagrahas, sabhas were set to launch the movement. But this satyagraha was turned out the first Indian struggle against the British government. Under this act, the British government arrested some local leaders in Punjab, in Amritsar. The people gathered to conduct the meeting. This meeting was a very peaceful meeting. But Punjab Governor Michael O. Dyer entered in Amritsar and he ordered his troop firing orders. Continue firing 10 minutes. In this instant, thousands of people died and thousands of people injured in this moment.
These were Jallianwala Bagh incident. pictures.
Rabindranath Tagore expressed pain and anger, renouncing his title or award knighthood, give back to the British government. In this incident, Hindus and Muslims united against struggling against the Britishers. And now we are going about the Khilafat movement. What is information of Khilafat movement? The British government horse treaty of Turkish Sultan means Khalifa. So this movement was called Khilafat movement. The leaders of Khilafat movement, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Shaukat Ali. Now we should to enter full-fledged non-cooperation movement. Gandhiji supported in this movement in India. Another major movement in this days, non-cooperation movement 1921-22. Gandhiji launched this movement. Gandhiji called for the people participate in this movement and said that the people should not cooperate the British government. So number of students boycott the schools and colleges. Number of officers and leaders resign their jobs. And many lawyers such as Motilal Nehru, Aruna Asaf Ali, Rajagopalachari give up their practice and boycott the legislatures. And another places, people burn the foreign goods and foreign cloths. Gandhiji call for the people to spin own cotton on charaka. Every house. So in this desire to make the self-reliant. Late phase of Indian national movement, Gandhiji adopted charaka as a symbol of Swadeshi. And the part of non-cooperation movement, Chirala Perala movement in Andhra Pradesh. It is under leadership Duggirala Gopala Krishnaya. Of Chirala Perala movement. The British government decided to convert the Chirala Perala as a municipality and force the high taxes. Some people against the converted the municipality. So they started the one movement that was called Chirala Perala movement. Duggirala Gopalakrishnaya refused the taxes and migrated a new settlement that was called Ram Nagar. This was a very powerful movement of land revenue of the peasants. People said, Gandhiji's Swaraj is coming, so we will not pay the tax to this government. Another major development movement in AP, Pulari Satyagraha, means forest satyagraha. The forest satyagraha, Palnad Taluka in Guntur district and Raichoti Taluka in Kadapa districts. So, the first satyagraha in Palnad Taluka. The peasants began to sending the herds of the cattle into the forest without paying the grazing fee to the British government. This was called Pulari Satyagraha. And another major incident in non-cooperation movement, Chauri Chaura incident. So, what are the incident? Gandhiji, as you know, against the violent movement. But unfortunately, non-cooperation movement turned out the violent movement. What was the violence movement? In February 1922, crowds of peasants set to fire the police station in Chauri Chaura. So this incident was called Chauri Chaura incident. Why was the peasant attack the police station? The police had a fight on their peaceful demonstration. So attack the peasants. So Gandhiji stopped the non-cooperation movement. Once stopped non-cooperation movement, Gandhiji and his followers were arrested. Now, I am telling about two developments in India. The RSS, Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh. This is a Hindu organization. Next, another development, Communist Party of India established. And another major development, the revolutionary nationalist Bhagat Singh was major active role in this period. Now, I am telling about the another movement, Civil Disobedience Movement. This movement launched the Gandhi and INC. So, the Indian National Congress met at Lahore. Under the leadership of the Jawaharlal Nehru. The Indian National Congress, one resolution passed. That means the Congress decided an attainment of the Purna Swaraj. Means total independence. National Congress launched the Civil Disobedient Movement. Gandhiji joined in this movement on March 22, 1930. Gandhiji decided the broken the British salt law by the manufacturing the salt at Dandi village. So, the next morning, Gandhiji and his followers began to 375 kilometers to Sabarmati Ashramam to Dandi village. So, this process was covered 24 days. Day by day, the newspapers spread their activities, their speeches, their progress to infect the people. So, hundreds of officers resigned their jobs and joined in this movement. And 6th April 1930, Gandhiji reached the Dandi village and picked up the handful salt. So, Gandhiji broke the British salt law. So, these movements salt law movements various places in India. Movements are important role in this movement. So another places foreign cloth shops and liquor shops burned the people. And students boycott the colleges and schools. In this movement, large number of people joined. So, but Britishers suppressed the movement, like British soldiers and police attack the people and by the lathi charge and firing the unarmed crowd of men and women. So, over 90,000 people arrested, include Gandhiji, arrested in the prison. So, and 110 people were killed and 300 people were injured in the lathi charge. So, in the world, one incident occurred. That is, Second World War. This is 1939 to 1945. So, the Second World War happened. The Second World War, Germany led by Hitler and his Nazi party wanted to gain control over the whole world and declared the war on Britain, France, USSR and other countries. Germany supported countries like Japan and Italy. One of the worst war in human history broke out the 1939 to 1945. USA dropped atom bomb over the Hiroshima and Nagasaki in Japan. However, India is created a dilemma as Indians were at the same time fighting against the Britishers. Now we are going to discussing about the another most important movement, Quit India Movement. Starting Quit India Movement. Britain wanted to use the people and money of the India for the Second World War. The Congress demanded that in return for support in the war, India should be given self-rule. But the British government refused that demand. The Congress Working Committee met on 8th August 1942 at Bombay and passed one resolution stating clearly that British rule in India must end immediately. In the evening after Quit India resolution was passed, the quit means leave India. So Gandhiji said some words in Indian paper. Everyone of you should from this moment onwards consider yourself free man and woman. As if you free man and woman, I am not going to be satisfied with the anything short of the complete freedom. We shall do or die. We shall either free India or die in the attempt. In this day, Gandhiji gave one slogan, do or die. August 1942, the government arrested most of the Congress leaders, mainly Gandhi and Vallabhbhai Patel, Nehru, Maulana Azad, Acharya Kripalani, Rajendra Prasad and other people protest the hartals and strike. Unfortunately, the movement turned the violent. Another places, people boycott their work. Students attack the police stations and post offices and railway stations and other public places. They cut off the telegraph and telephone and railway lines. They burned the government buildings and vehicles and melted vehicles and railway carriages. Madras, Bombay was most affected in this moment. 30 policemen and 10 army men lost their life. Many people died and thousands of people arrested. Anyhow, last the British government suppressed in this moment. By end of 1943, over 90,000 people arrested and around the 1,000 killed in the police firing. Now we are going to discussing about the Subhash Chandra Bose. Subhash Chandra Bose had been a Swaraj and a radical nationalist. He organized the Indian National Army with the cooperation of Ras Bihari Bose in Burma and Andaman. In Indian National Congress, consists of more than 60,000 soldiers. On 21st October 1943, the Provincial Government of Independence India, this is also called Azad Hindu Fauj. Subhash Chandra Bose, gave one important slogan. Chalo Delhi. This is very important in this lesson. August 23rd, 1945, Subhash Chandra Bose was reported to have lost his life in an air crashing while going up from Bangkok to Tokyo. Now, we are going to discuss about the towards the independent and partition of India. In 1940, Muslim League had moved one resolution demanding independent state for Muslims in the northwestern and eastern areas of the country. That means separate state. The Congress rejection of the League's decision in the form of Joint Congress of the League, the government is united, the provinces 1937. In March 1946, the British government sent the three members, one of the mission, that was Cripps mission. The main leaders of Britishers were Sir Stafford Cripps, Alexander and Patrick Lawrence. These members sent to Delhi to examine the demand and suggest the suitable framework from India. This mission suggested that India should be remain united India. As the proposal of cabinet mission failed, the Muslim League decided on mass agitation in support of its demand for partition. It announced 16th August August 1946 as the direct action day. On this day, riots broke out into the Calcutta, lasting the several days and resulting in thousands of people. And British government again one officer appointed, that was called Louis Mountbatten, Viceroy. In 1947, he was discussing with the Muslim League and Congress Party. Finally, he was agreed that India split into the Muslim control the Pakistan and Hindus dominated the India. India became the independence on 5th August 1947. While Pakistan celebration its independence on 14th August. Even after partition, many lakhs of people were killed. And lakhs of people were forced to flee their homes. So, the joy of our country's independence from British rule came to mixed with pain and violence of the partition. Anyhow, however, these three stages give us independence. So, I hope all of you understand the national moment lesson. Thank you.